just shy of it.
Well, each week we're taking time to reflect, accompanied by some music. So this week you have a finger labyrinth in your bulletin. Did everybody get a labyrinth?
Mine doesn't look that big.
No, got a little version. I needed a big one so you could see it. So this is a finger labyrinth. So labyrinths are an ancient Christian practice that was designed for an experience of pilgrimage. So you're invited to slowly follow the path with your finger, opening to and listening for the intuition, the small voice inside of you, nudging you in the path that brings your life the most fullness.
Now that you're out in the wilderness, let's see how you do.
Help me, God. So do you have joys or concerns that you would like to share this morning?
Well, Eric's still waiting for his heart. I told him I'd give him mine, but he said he didn't want one over 80 years old. And Dennis hasn't heard anything on his operation yet.
Okay, so... lots of waiting with her family.
I have concern for Maynard. Last Sunday, we went around each of the kids and told them that he's been taking tests and has gone through x-rays and a couple of scans. And we got the call that Wednesday they will do the biopsy at the Holthrod Cancer Center. And he will decide and know what they're offering as a...
both of you in our prayers, especially this week as you do the biopsy. autopsy and find out more about what's going on. Thanks for sharing.
Tom and Peg were in a hit and run accident.
Really?
Yes, they were staying in a motel because there's been so much water down there. And they're only, part of a block from a creek. And they're afraid they wouldn't get to work. So they stay at a motel on base. Well, it wasn't a motel. They stay on base.
Mm-hmm.
And I know they were in a car going back out, and this guy hit them. The fender, front fender, a wheel, and the front door. And then Fred got out of the car, and she fell. She just bunged herself up. She didn't hurt anything, really.
But
that was big for yesterday.
So,
and she said, she didn't know the kind of car it was or anything. All she knew was Tam.
And they didn't stop.
It almost had to be someone on base because they... No one else is in it.
Could have been your car. It's Sam, too.
Yeah.
I know.
So we want to keep them in our prayers as they sort all that out.
It's a joy to have Leo and Margaret.
Yes.
This is a family.
Yes. Very good.
Working along.
Yes. Very good to have you with us.
You can tell it's not near as quiet as it usually is.
Continue to keep you in our prayers, Margaret, as you continue to heal.
A long way to go yet.
Yeah. Well, do you think we can remember our Come and Rest song? Come and Rest. Is it in your bulletin?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, it's in that bulletin.
Oh, cool. All right. Let us sing. We'll sing it through twice, but don't do the echoes. Okay. Come and rest, come and listen. Lay the fullness of your lives before the Maker. Come and rest, come and listen. Lay the fullness of your lives before the Maker. Let us pray. Gracious and holy God, we are thankful that you fill us with all those gifts and passions that make us come alive. We pray that you might continue to speak to us as we sort things out in our lives, that even in our everyday activities, that you show us what you would like us to do. God, we lift up all of those who are walking in the dark woods for many reasons. We pray that each one of these we have lifted up today, here, that they might know your healing, that they might feel your arms of comfort around them, that you will continue to lead their paths, and that you might give them strength and hope. We are thankful for the many blessings you give to us, the blessings of family and friends, the blessing of this faith community. And we also, as a community of faith, continue to listen to your words for us. We pray that we might follow your path that encompasses our passions and our gifts, so that we might share the love of Jesus Christ with others. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. And we pray together now that prayer he taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
And now let us receive our morning tithe and offerings.
Morning, you heard Pastor Mark talk about the Jesus being put out in the wilderness. You know, you learn things as far as when you experience it. But then again, he could have taken a seminar. You know, maybe a 5-hour one would have been more than a plenty. Turns out, I think back 25 years ago, when you learn something, you retain it longer than you actually do it. Did you miss you? Did I get on this morning? Fine, just wanted to check. Get a couple of you. 25 years ago, we were taking the first responder class down in Mechanicsville. And the first thing you learn is scene safety, keep yourself safe. You know, you're not getting paid enough to put your life in jeopardy. Well, so to speak. You are expendable. But anyway, as it turned out, about halfway through the class or better, we didn't know that, but in, I think, a February night, Mechanicsville pulled their ambulance and that outside. They pulled a big old car, which, you know, people now call a boat, and maybe some Buick into the, their fire station, and had some more of their EMTs there. That's where we were taking the class at the time. And they had a table set up with all the supplies that we would need medically. And besides that, as far as they had people there, as far as the, had five patients in the car, from, you know, mother, father, as far as two kids, no, six, I guess. And as far as the little baby, we did find the baby. It was crunched underneath the seat in this accident. Always got to look everywhere. And then Grandpa, basically, you know, he's a harmless old man, but he had AIDS. He did not practice other safe procedures in his lifetime, okay? So, and a doctor that was real handy with a needle, he could help. He could give people a shot. Well, we couldn't use the doctor, because unless that's a patient doctor and we get it right, it's no good. So we went through the procedure, you know, just all of us. We didn't expect it. It's, hey, we got an accident, go out there and do it. And we did. We did wonderful. When we recapped everything at the end, did this right, did that right, did that right, you know, regardless. Got rid of that doctor, just wouldn't accept his advice. You know, we didn't do any unnecessary things with Grandpa, who was not a safe guy. And we found the baby. Now, the whole thing come down to one thing. We forgot to put on our gloves. Every one of us students in that class, I think it was 16 or so, forgot to put on a glove. Now believe me, I never forgot to wear my gloves again, because safety comes first, but it sticks in your mind. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him, all of the heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Let us pray together. Gracious God, we rejoice in your tender care for us when we are in the dark woods of life. You nurture us by your word and spirit. You strengthen our faith, so that we will live to praise you. May our congregation's outreach ministries be a source of vitality for people in our wider community. We dedicate these gifts in Jesus' name. Amen. So our closing hymn is Spirit, Spirit of Gentleness, 2120 in the Faith We Sing.
Do we have the hymnals open just in case?
I don't know.
But we have the resurrection up there, so.
Yeah, that's really good.